These are three rare original silk screens by Cuban artist Rene Mederos. They date from 1969. They were ripped up and in very poor condition, and they needed a Posterfix. Hi, I'm Chris, and welcome to another edition of Posterfix Studio. These silk screens are very rare.
Well, 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 what have we got here?
Rene Mederos was a Cuban-born artist who worked in Cuba and depicted the Vietnam War, which you see on these silk screens. These date from 1969 and are part of a very famous series of work that made him world famous. What you're going to see me do first is prepare a screen for linen backing. I'm going to mix wheat paste. This wheat paste is similar to the stuff used in wallpaper paste. However, it's a finer grade of it, and I add an acid neutralizing agent. Now I take out the acid-free paper and I start to get it wet so that it can be applied to the canvas. The wetness helps the paper to expand before I apply the wheat paste to it. This will be how we linen back the poster. The poster will be applied to this acid-free paper and canvas once this is prepared. All this while, the paper has been expanding because it's got wheat paste all over it. Now, I've got to stretch out the paper before I roll it out. Rolling it out will help to push out the excessive air pockets and air bubbles and excessive wheat paste and make the paper nice and flat. Thank you.
posters mounted to it.
And now we're ready to lay these posters down on the linen backing, which you will see us do after this commercial break. So don't go away. Welcome back to Posterfix. I'm now linen backing the three silk screens by Rene Mederos.
Putting the wheat paste down on the acid-free paper directly, and then I'm going to lie the print right on top of it. Because of the fragility of the poster, I think it's a safer way to go. Spraying water on it to help it absorb and expand. This appears to be a silk screen.
These silk screens are very rare, scarce in fact. Rene Mederos was a Cuban-born artist who worked in Cuba and depicted the Vietnam War, which you see on these silk screens. These date from 1969 and are part of a very famous series of work that made him world famous. From Wikipedia, Rene Mederos, Felix Rene Mederos Pazos, was born November 20th, 1933, and died on September 24th, 1996. Rene Mederos was a prominent Cuban poster artist and graphic designer.
Already the linen backing has repaired it as far as the rips are concerned. After it's dry, we'll do the touch-up. Now let's linen back the next one. Perhaps this time I'll put the glue directly on the paper. It seems strong enough.
Mederos, a self-taught artist from Sagua La Grande, began work in a Havana print shop in 1944. And was appointed chief designer for Cuba's principal television station in 1959. In 1964, at the beginning of the new wave of Cuban graphic design, Mederos began creating his first posters as head of the design team of the propaganda organization, Intercommunications. In 1969, Mederos was assigned by the Department of Revolutionary Orientation to travel to Vietnam to paint scenes of the war, like these. These are examples of those from that series. Mederos traveled to both North and South Vietnam along the Ho Chi Minh Trail with the Liberation Forces, experiencing firsthand the brutal conditions of war and the courageous response of the Vietnamese people.
This is absorbing the wheat paste very evenly. I'm impressed because sometimes silk screens don't always absorb evenly. They tend to absorb differently where there are inks, and then absorb more where there are no inks, and that creates problems. But that's not happening here, at least not yet. two down, one to go.
The paintings were exhibited in Hanoi and were subsequently reproduced as a screen-printed series which has been shown all over the world. These prints are world famous and very rare. Mederos, on another trip to Vietnam in 1972, added to the body of work. Several of these images were reproduced in the United States as part of the anti-war and Cuba solidarity efforts, and in Cuba as a set of postage stamps. He also contributed to the solidarity posters produced by the Organization of Solidarity with the People of Asia, Africa, and Latin America, which enjoyed worldwide distribution through the magazine Tricontinental. In 1973, Mederos created a series of valas, which were 12-sheet billboards, on the history of the Cuban Revolution, as well as a series of screen prints commemorating the 20th anniversary of the assault on the Moncada, the event signaling the beginning of the armed resistance to the Batista government. He continued to design 12-sheet billboards and posters for the Department of Revolutionary Orientation and its successor, Editoria Politica, on a wide range of domestic and international issues. In 1991, Mederos visited the United States for the first time, where he designed and painted a mural at UCLA on U.S.-Vietnam solidarity. His last major project was a 14-panel portable mural series on Che Guevara. Mederos died of cancer in Havana in 1996. His style, with its bright, firmly contoured surfaces, its ebullience of patterns in nature, and a strong political theme, established a unique standard for graphic design in Cuba, which influenced a whole generation of graphic artists all over the world. And that from Wikipedia. It's interesting that the word communist or communism never shows up in that article, since he was working in communist Cuba and his depictions in these posters so show sympathy for the North Vietnamese. At any rate, the United States is friendly with all of Vietnam now, and that is a good thing.
The paper in these posters is very resilient and expands really well. They're also very strong. Meaning that the paper is strong. It resists. I've put some pieces of wood on either end of the posters because they seem to be lifting a little bit off the sides, and if I put the weight down on them for about 10 minutes, it should help them stay fastened. Okay, I've been letting these posters sit here with weights on them, and the weights seem to have flattened them out so that they're not coming up on the edges anymore. And now they're sharing the screen with these World War I
American posters. And we're gonna let this screen dry for a few days before we trim it down. All right, well, we've got this screen all completed. The three posters are sharing space with these other American World War I posters. We're gonna let the screen dry for a few days. We're gonna do the restoration on the screen, paper fills. Then we'll trim it down and complete the touch-up. Don't go away. You're gonna see all that.
Welcome back to Posterfix. The screen is now dried, and my wife Oki is going into the poster with paper pulp to fill in the areas, the holes, with an artificial paper compound. Once dry, it will be touched up. I don't think artificial compound is the correct phrase. It's a compound made with paper powder, acid-free paper powder mixed with methyl cellulose. And it dries as a paper. It's very good for filling in cracks. It's archival and water-based, acid neutral. I found another article on Wikipedia concerning Cuban propaganda. Let's take a look at that. The Cuban Revolution was not only fought by armed rebels on the battlefield, but also through the propaganda campaigns designed and orchestrated by Fidel Castro and his rebel comrades. Propaganda in Cuba during the revolution included Castro's use of personal interviews with journalists, radio broadcasts, and publicity-seeking operations that contributed significantly to the victory of the rebels over Batista's government and provided insight into the successful propaganda campaign established by Castro after gaining power. The limited yet successful revolutionary propaganda apparatus transitioned into what Castro has called one of the most potent weapons in his foreign policy arsenal. Today, the Cuban government maintains an intricate propaganda machine that includes a global news agency, magazines, newspapers, broadcasting facilities, publishing houses, front groups, and other miscellaneous organizations all stem from the modest beginnings of Castro's revolutionary propaganda machine. Well, it's interesting that when they talk of Adolf Hitler in propaganda, the sinister aspect of it all is more honestly dealt with. I'm getting a sense that Wikipedia is actually preferential towards communism and the communist revolution, rarely using the term communism at all in any of these entries on Wikipedia. It's kind of shocking. It's really misinformation, false history. And that's what I get for trusting Wikipedia. I never go to Wikipedia for religious material. But one thing I do know, all of our restoration techniques are archival and water reversible and help to extend the longevity of your poster. And I'll restore anything. I am using water reversible gouache as the paint for retouching these silkscreen Cuban posters. Linen backing silkscreens can be a tricky matter sometimes. They don't always absorb wheat paste evenly. Oftentimes, parts of the poster that have ink on them have a different absorption rate than parts of the poster which are uninked. Fortunately, these posters are pretty much inked all the way through, and there is no uninked paper showing except for the margin. Also, this paper is quite substantial. Not quite as thick as cardstock, but not as thin as paper either. Posterfix try to maintain a certain degree of neutrality towards the subject matter of the posters, considering the fact that most historical posters can embrace things which are not always politically correct. Our job is to save artifacts of history, not to judge history. After 33 years of restoring vintage posters, neutrality is the best way to go. You get more business that way. '69 communist Cuban silk screens are complete. If you have any questions about the restoration of your vintage posters, don't hesitate to send me an email telling me the size and condition of the poster, show me some photos of the posters, and if possible, photograph the back of them too if there are issues that I should know about on the back, like writing or tape or residue of some kind. I look forward to seeing your posters and getting back to you with an estimate for the restoration work. Thank you.